first prayer that we are going to offer is called adoration. Brother Ronald Robert will lead us in the prayer of adoration. two more sets of prayer. We have adored God, we have confessed our sins. Now is the time to thank God. Jesus healed 10 lepers, but 9 went their way, but there's only one who returned to Jesus. I want you to think of all the blessings that you've received from God. Would you please be grateful enough to come very humbly to the foot of the cross and say, Lord, thank you. I want you to say thank you to God for what He has done. Father in heaven, we thank you for what you've done for each and every one of us. Would you please stretch both your hands, place them on your beloved people. They have come here because they want to remain thankful and grateful to you. Thank you for the lovely children. Thank you for the children's choir. Thank you for the ladies' choir. Thank you for the men of music. Thank you for the 8 singing groups that you brought. Thank you for IRIS, an International Institute of Advanced Studies, that is imparting values, eternal values. Praise God for the Christian education. Thank you for this wonderful promise. Thank you for Lucy. Thank you for Scylla. Thank you for all the Barabbas. Thank you for your people. Thank you for dying on the cross. Accept our thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Amen. We're going to have our last prayer in Acts. Adoration, confession, thanksgiving, and supplication. What is your supplication? I want each of you to look into your own lives. What is it that troubles you? Do you have a challenge this afternoon? Maybe you're going through some rough time in your business. Maybe your finances are pretty bad. Maybe you're not getting along with your employer. Your employee is too bad. Maybe your spouse is not treating you well. Maybe your children are disrespecting you. Maybe your parents are not good to you. Maybe your grandfather or grandmother is sick. Maybe your uncle has cancer. You have some challenges. Students, maybe you don't understand certain things. Come on, this is the time for you to talk to Jesus. Lord, hear my prayer. Jesus says, ask and it shall be given. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be opened. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus by faith. The last prayer is a personal prayer for 30 seconds. Come to Jesus. Tell him, Lord, please, please, hear my prayer. Shall we talk to God? Thank the Lord for hearing our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you so much. To begin our program, we have IS Orchestra here. I want to call upon Mr. Cedric Langell with his kids. Shall we all put our hands together and invite IS Orchestra?
hand. Maybe you don't know well, but the first song was the story of a bird, sparrow. A small bird that you can see around you every day. But you saw through the whole song, you have this kind of prayer. A little sparrow is happy. But you know, like in the Philippines, like in other countries, typhoon appears. Problems appear, and when problems appear, you have all this music problems, and you, but finally, through all the experience of life, you see that sparrow can still praise God for all the food and everything. And the second song that you have with children was the marching medley. You have also this march. Sometimes it's easy to march all together, and sometimes it's a little bit harder. And finally, all on the way are going the march to Zion. I will present two more songs. One is There Is a Savior. There is a Savior, I think, the one we are praying every day for. The Savior that we believe is answering our prayer. And then the following one is There Is a King. There is a Savior, there is a King. Thank you.
because I'm also quite numerous. I did pray, but I didn't have enough faith that God would answer my prayer. There is something that I would like to humbly request. There are so many people standing outside at the back. There is right now a need to push a little forward. So this is not about the spiritual push. Will you physically push a little bit right now? Because there are so many people, there is a need for us to follow 100 chairs. Thank you for pushing. This is what happens when we pray. When we pray until something happens, there is also a need. Yes. Just keep pushing forward a little bit. I would like to now invite Dr. Shivilo De Castro to kindly come forward. You may be seated, please. I will truly praise God. We are hoping that we will have some more chairs coming in the next few minutes. I would like to very specially interview one of our guests. His name is Paul Shivilo De Castro. He is a medical doctor by profession, and to tell you very specifically, he is a sports medicine specialist. He treats all the actors, actresses, sports stars in this great country of the Philippines. I happened to go to Manila one of these days, and I was so blessed that I was able to meet him. And as we were talking on the divine service, he said, "Hey, Pastor Paul, I would like to do something for God." You know, doctors always have a lot of money. Will you say amen?
Amen.
Amen. While pastors don't have much money. So I told him, "Sir, I will pray and you will pay." He said, "That's a good deal." He said, "What shall we do?" "I want you to come to my baranga. It's called Silan. There is a place called Premier Plaza." So we looked for a place. We were originally planning to hold it right over there. And when I consulted with the administration, we were not able to hold there because we were expecting. I had the faith for 150 people, but currently there are more than 350 people. Amen.
Amen.
I want to apologize. Shall we give God the glory? Amen. Praise God for what He has done. This is what happens when we pray. This is a time for us to pray. Doctor, I want to ask you a question. Why would you want to invest your money on something like this? I don't see any advertisement, you don't sell any products, you're not marketing. Why would you want to spend your money for prayer? Can you tell us?
Good afternoon, everyone.
Yes.
Happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath.
I'm sorry if I become a little emotional seeing all of you right now today.
Well, praise God that you're praised for your answer. Okay, let's give him some time. We will try to call upon someone. His heart and his passion has always been into evangelism. Children, do you see this is a prime example of what happens when you pray? Let's all put our hands together as we welcome our chief guest today, the president of IRIS, Dr. Steve Duncan. Thank you so much for joining us for this push program. I want to give you a few moments that you will lead us into some prayerful remarks. God bless.
This is what happens when you don't have enough hands. There in Luke 11, in the Bible book Luke, in the chapter 11, the disciples were watching Jesus. And as they watched Jesus, they saw him often kneeling down and praying. Often he would do this in the early morning, sometimes during the day, sometimes at night, sometimes hours at a time. And they saw the sincerity of how he prayed. It was different than other people prayed. Sometimes they saw religious figures raising their voice, waving their hands, making a big show of prayer. And they saw other people doing other kinds of religious acts. But Jesus seemed to be different. He seemed to be sincerely talking to God, like you would talk to a friend. And so they said to Jesus, "Lord, teach us to pray like you. We want to learn to pray like you." Do you have that feeling today? Do you have that feeling like, I would like to be able to talk to God like Jesus talked to God? What a wonderful thing. You know, people today, they pray in different ways. I took this picture one time in Nepal. Here, this lady was praying, and the way she prayed was by spinning those barrels. They had a prayer inside the barrel, and you spin the prayer. The more times it went around, they thought, well, the more prayers I'm offering. Sometimes you see this lady here. This is also in one of another country. She had some beads there, and she was going through the beads one by one, by one, by one, by one. Not even thinking. Even while she was talking to me, she was doing these beads. And she had the feeling that maybe if I went through enough beads, maybe somehow, you know, God would know what I wanted. He would somehow connect with me. And we see people using different ways. Sometimes they burn candles. Sometimes they bring flowers. Sometimes they burn incense. Different ways of trying to communicate with God. I don't know when you came here today. I don't know what you wanted to pray about. People pray for all kinds of different things. Sometimes they pray when they're worshiping. Sometimes they pray to God for forgiveness for something terrible that they have done. Sometimes people pray for healing when they get sick. Or maybe they pray for their children or for some loved one who they feel like is not going the way that they should. Not living the kind of life that they really should live. Sometimes they pray that God will bless somebody. Maybe help them out of a difficult situation. You know, the wonderful thing that is that God is the kind of God that wants to talk to you. God is not somebody up there that is mean and stern, that doesn't want to communicate. In fact, the only way that you'll be able to talk to him is if you can find a friend or a relative or somebody that can connect you with him. God is like a father. And he is so eager to hear from his children. And he wants you to talk to him. He's eager for you to talk to him. So as we read this story in Luke chapter 11, we find that Jesus is trying to communicate with his disciples to say, God the Father is your Father. And it's interesting, the word that Jesus uses as he talks to the disciples is not even the word Father. You know, Father is kind of a formal term, but it was really more the familiar term, more like what we would say Daddy. And so Jesus is saying, you have to think about him as your daddy, somebody who loves you so much. He's eager to talk with you. When you go to him and you say, I need help for my child. Maybe you're having financial problems. Maybe it's an issue of health. You're talking to somebody who loves you very much, who cares for you. Yes, this is a sinful world. Yes, there's bad things. And someday Jesus is going to bring an end to all of that. But now we have a way to connect with God, to communicate with him. And we can do it carefully just by saying, Dear Daddy. Just now, I would like to pray with you. Would you like to pray? Let's pray to God as a heavenly daddy. Let's think about him as somebody who wants to hear from us. Let's bow our heads and pray. Loving Father in heaven, our spiritual daddy, even though you're the creator of the world, even though you are the redeemer and salvation of all things, even though you can speak the word and create, still somehow you have chosen to be our friend, to be our savior, to be our creator. And Lord, we thank you that you want to talk to us and that you want to hear from us. Lord, we come to you just now. Oh, there are many things on our hearts. Our first thing is that we want to praise you and give you glory because there is no one like you, God. We want you to be part of our lives. We want you to speak to us. And we want to talk to you. We want you to have a part in our life, Lord. Today, yes, we recognize that we've done some things that are not good. And we want to just put them in front of you, Lord. And even though we've done some bad things, Lord, and we've sinned, we know just like a parent does not throw away their children when they do something wrong, they still love them. And you still love us in spite of what we've done wrong. Lord, help us to turn from our sins and not disappoint you because we love you so much, Lord. Lord, there's some in our midst here who may have challenges with finances. They may have challenges with health, with their health. Lord, we just pray today that you will touch them. You can do a miracle. If you created the world, you can do a miracle, Lord. So we ask you today, don't hold back. If somebody needs that special miracle, we pray that you will give them that help. If they need help in their lives, maybe in a financial way or other ways, we pray that you give them the needs of their heart. But Lord, we ask these things not selfishly. We ask these things in a way that if this is not best for us, Lord, we want you to give us the best thing, even if it means saying no to some of our requests, because sometimes we're kind of selfish. So, Lord, we want to trust you to give us the very best of what we need. Lord, we thank you for this time here in Siloam, when we can come together and talk with you and pray. Lord, I pray that you will bless every single person who has come here today. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen.
Welcome to the prayer festival at Siloam.
watch as these young people are watching for. a meeting of this nature will never be complete if you don't listen from this book. Especially, I want to challenge those of you who have brought your good friends from seven churches who are here. We're going to listen to the voice of God, and we're going to listen to what the Bible says, and we're going to listen from a pastor. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a program entitled Ask the Pastor, and I'm going to ask two very important sections of issues with him. Shall we all put our hands together and welcome Pastor Richard Sabui. Here we go.
Sustaining the faith of believers and provided comfort for many in need. You run one of the largest hospital systems in America, and your individual churches are providing hope and inspiration to countless Americans every week. Thanks for your fine works of love and peace, hope. America is a better place because of you. May God bless you all. May God continue to bless America.
It's an honor to address the members of the Seventh-day Adventist Church. I am flattered and humbled to have this chance to speak to such a vibrant and active group of people. One of the things I admire most about Seventh-day Adventists, in addition to your faith, is your commitment to preach, teach, and heal. Your emphasis on educating and nurturing your fellow man and woman is a model for all people of faith to follow. And your network of schools and healthcare facilities put into action the tenets of those beliefs. For that is the calling to all of us, not just to believe, but to act, to be true to our beliefs and to fully express our faith. We need freedom. Our religious freedom is a cornerstone of this great nation. And I personally appreciate the work of the Seventh-day Adventist Church in promoting religious freedom, not just here, but around the world. I am particularly proud to join you in supporting the Workplace Religious Freedom Act. When I think of what a good and decent society should look like, I imagine one in which the government does not hinder faith, but rather recognizes what people of faith do to make our communities stronger and to make our families stronger as well. Families, after all, are the building block of any society. I know the Seventh-day Adventist Church has a strong commitment to family, a commitment that is represented in how we observe the Sabbath together. With faith and strong families and the freedom to allow faith to prosper, our people and our nation will be ready to embrace the future. Thank you again for inviting me to address you. May God bless you and your families. May God bless the Seventh-day Adventist Church. And may God bless our dear and beloved country, the United States of America.
My second question would ask this someone. I see two phrases there, Seventh-day Adventist. Could you explain to us what is Seventh-day entire? What is Adventist? Could you please explain to us, Pastor?
Thank you, Pastor. Seventh-day is related to creation. We believe that God created heavens and earth on 6 days, for 6 days, and on the seventh day, God rested. So we call our name as the Seventh-day Adventist because we believe in God who created the universe. We believe that after creating this universe, after creating heaven and earth, then God rested on the seventh day. The seventh day is intended to bring God and His creature, and in this sense, us human beings, to be close to one another. And Adventist stands or represent the concept of the coming of Christ, the coming of the one who created us, the coming of the one who died for us on the cross. This is the one that we have been waiting for. So, by calling the name the Seventh-day Adventist, we believe in what happened back then to the very ancient day, and that is creation. And we believe in what will take place later in the future, and that is the second coming of Christ.
Which church do you attend here, sir? Which church do you attend here in Islam?
Pardon?
Which church do you attend?
I am a member of the IS Seventh-day Adventist Church. It is about 10 minutes walking distance from here.
Can you tell us the name of your pastor, your church pastor?
My church pastor is Pastor Laudimer Gatus. He's from the Philippines.
Pastor Laudimer Gatus, if you're here, please come forward right now.
Yeah, this is my church pastor.
Okay. Yes. Please come forward. Council, we are very happy to welcome. This is the first time a foreigner is welcoming a Filipino. Thank you so much. Could you tell us how to come to your church and how often do you have your church service? Supposing if I want to bring my family from Silla, how can I come to your church?
For those who are in Silang, we would like to invite you. Our services is during Friday evening, 7 o'clock to 8 o'clock. And then Sabbath morning, that is Saturday, 8:45 in the morning until 12 noon. For those who are coming from Silang, it's quite a trippy going to Dalaman, but you're not going to reach Balubat, and then you just tell the driver you're going to start there at Ayas. You know Ayas for sure, all the different drivers here.
Thank you so much. This brings us to the end of the first part of Ask the Pastor. If there is anyone here who is still struggling with the fact who created me, I think today beyond the shadow of any doubt, after listening to the Word of God, listening to those testimonies, listening from the pastor based on the Word of God. God created this world in 6 days. Shall we say amen?
Amen.
On the seventh day, not on any other day, rested, blessed, and sanctified. The same Jesus who established this day came and he died for you and me. He's gone back. And for all those who are looking forward for the soon return of Jesus Christ, we have this blessed assurance and hope. That's what Adventism is all about. Shall we thank Pastor Samuel for joining us? Shall we put our hands together? Thank you, Pastor. At this time, we're going to have the children's choir come up to the front. These are lovely children coming all the way from Ayers. I need to give you some kind of an exercise, right? Your only exercise will be to keep clapping. Why don't you clap one more time as we welcome the children's choir?
To the end of this.